Hello and welcome to Therapy Express with Rosanna. Thank you so much for watching. Today we are going to talk about people pleasers. I'm going to ask you about four questions, and if you answer yes to two or more of those questions, there's a chance that you might be a people pleaser. Now, you might be thinking to yourself, so what's wrong with that? You know, you want to make people happy, right? Sure, there's nothing wrong with wanting to make people happy. But when it's to the extreme, when you want to make people happy at your own expense, then we have a little problem. So let's get on to the questions. Number one, are you constantly always trying to make people happy, even when it means that you have to sacrifice something that you want to do or you want to say? If you're constantly trying to make people happy, that's one of the first signs. Number two, do you constantly say yes when you really want to say no? When it's like a pressure saying yes, yes, but in your heart of hearts, you say, I don't really want to do this. If you're saying yes and you really want to say no, that's another little red flag there. That's number two. Number three, are you constantly seeking validation and approval from other people? If you are, that's another sign, because you don't feel good enough about yourself and you are looking for that approval externally. If that's the case, of course you would say yes because you want people to like you and accept you. And number four, when you say no, does it feel harsh to you? Does it feel like you're being very rude? If so, that's another sign. Now, how did you do? Did you answer yes to all those questions? If so, you might be a people pleaser. I'm going to give you an example of sort of an extreme case. I used to treat this woman who came to me because she had a lot of issues with her family. One of them was that she was a people pleaser. She couldn't say no. So on this particular day, she was getting ready to go to a concert with her two friends. She had the tickets. Everything was good to go. Her daughter showed up with the three kids at her doorstep just as she was about to exit. And the daughter says, Mom, you got to take care of the kids. I have something to do. I got to go to work or blah, blah, blah. My client, instead of saying, oh, honey, I'm sorry, but I'm on my way out. She didn't say that. She told her friends, oh, I'm sorry, I can't make it. And then she told the daughter, okay. Obviously, she didn't want to watch the kids. She had plans for the night. And she felt very resentful, but she did it anyway. And we had to work on that for weeks and months about her getting the strength to be able to say no. So when you start saying no, there is some backlash. And people are not going to want to accept that because they're used to manipulating you. They're used to getting what they want. Okay? So I'm going to give you some tips so you can end this cycle. Because people who are people pleasers usually walk around with an undercurrent of resentment and anger because they're always saying yes to things and they really don't want to do that. So let's get to the tips, all right? The number one is to realize that you have a choice. Imagine having a little box that says yes or a little box that says no. You have the choice, the freedom to be able to check the no box. It's your right on this earth, and you don't have to do it and feel guilty about it. Just say, no, I'm not going to do it. So that's number one. Recognize you have that choice. Number two, stall. You don't have to always answer right away. If somebody says, hey, can you do this for me? You can say, I don't know. Give me some time to think about it. I'm not sure what's going on. Then you can go home in the privacy of your own home. You can think about it. And if you really want to do it without any resentment, okay, go ahead and do it. But if you feel something in there that says, oh, God, I don't want to do this, but I have to. That's when you say no. And that's number three. Say no with conviction. Don't be wishy-washy about it. Don't like, I guess, no, No, I'm sorry, I can't do it. That's it. Maybe next time. Just this time, I'm unable to do it. And don't keep apologizing and making excuses, okay? Because that's going to make you feel like you're wishy-washy and you don't want to give that impression. You just want to say no. And it's okay to say no. You have to learn this, okay? Number four is to set some boundaries. So if you agree to take care of the grandkids for an hour, then make sure you stick to that. Don't let them get away with coming up 5 hours later to pick them up, whatever. You know, just say it's an hour and you need to be here at that time, period. And so people are going to start recognizing that you say what you mean. And number five, which is the last one, is to understand that not everybody is going to like you all the time. You can't please all people, and that's okay. You have to like yourself. You have to appreciate that you have freedoms in this world, that people can't walk all over you and just get what they want. After all, they're manipulating you. If you feel really bad and you think, well, they're not going to like me anymore, well, think about it. If someone isn't going to like you because you say no, then maybe you need to reassess that relationship in your life. Okay? I hope these have been helpful to you. And if you are a people pleaser, make sure you follow these techniques. And I think you'll really get a lot of benefit. Don't worry about how long it takes. Just start working toward that goal. Okay. All right, you guys. Thank you so much again for watching and supporting this channel. Click on the subscribe button, turn on your notifications, and look for me next week. Until then, make every moment count. Bye.